The toolkit is the only national toolkit in Australia setting out all of the jurisdictional obligations and laws when it comes to the protection and safety of children. With your help, together with the help of our community, the Institute of Community Directors Australia, Save the Children and Childwise, we aim to ensure that every single organisation in Australia providing services to children will implement the steps in the toolkit to ensure the safety of our children.
The data we have before us now tells us that one in four girls and one in seven boys will be sexually abused as a child. These figures don't even take into account neglect, physical abuse or emotional abuse. This is not good enough. The onus is on boards and those in positions of authority to put the needs of the child first, to have adequate protocols in place and to listen openly to allegations. Today's toolkit will help boards with these measures. This toolkit has one aim. It was designed as a tool to completely eradicate child abuse in our communities and especially in the not-for-profit sector. What the Royal Commission has found in their research is that most community groups fail to properly identify perpetrators or to know what to look for when concerns are raised. I'm here to tell you that this toolkit is an important part of the solution for your community group. This toolkit should be your first port of call when hiring someone who's going to be working with or volunteering with children. It should be your first port of call when you want to sample policy, procedure or code of conduct when it comes to child safety. And it should be a document read and understood at board level. Indeed, incorporating child safety as a part of any good governance program is something I'm focused on in my new role as Chair of the Community Directors Council. I'd like each and every one of you to take this resource back to your workplace, tell your community about it, share the link to the free download to your child's childcare centre or school or sporting group. Let's make sure that together we make the resource a document that lives out its mission to eradicate child abuse in its entirety.
Things like this toolkit, you think, sometimes, I think anyway, shouldn't be necessary. We should all just have a duty of care to mankind. But unfortunately, people need it written down and to be told how you should treat children. Now, when you go through child abuse, it doesn't just go away. You know, for 34 years, what I went through hung on my shoulders every single day, and it controlled everything that I did. It ruined relationships, it ruined careers, it ruined me. And I went through drug and alcohol abuse and everything, trying to mask it, put on that fake smile that we see so many do, but still hurting on the inside. So I wanted to test myself and also find out what I went through on the paddle and why did I change. And how can I bottle that to give it to other people in such a simple form? So I went on ridiculous events. But I get to work out what happened on the paddle and process everything that, how I got through every stage of my life, through all the tough times, and how I dealt with it. To be able to simplify that, to be able to help other people now. And so that's what I do. Yeah, and that's what's so important about this toolkit. As well, organisations that now know what they should do to help kids towards their future so they don't have to wait 34 years and paddle ridiculous miles to get over it. We can stop it beforehand.